In this video, we're going to be learning about ionic half equations. During electrolysis, the ions are discharged at the electrodes, where they either lose or gain electrons to form their corresponding elements. For example, during the electrolysis of lead bromide, the positively charged lead ions will gain electrons at the cathode to form the metal lead. The gain of electrons is known as reduction, and the lead ions are said to have been reduced. The negatively charged bromide ions will lose electrons at the anode, where they form bromine atoms, which combine to form bromine molecules. The loss of electrons is called oxidation, and the bromide ions are said to have been oxidized. To help you learn the definition of these key terms, oxidation and reduction, the mnemonic oil rig can be used, which stands for oxidation is the loss of electrons and reduction is the gain of electrons. Ionic half equations show the reactions that happen at each electrode. One half equation will show the gain of electrons, known as reduction, at the cathode, and the other will show the loss of electrons, known as oxidation, at the anode. Some of these examples are shown here. As with any other symbol equation, the number of atoms or ions for each element should be balanced, but in addition, you must make sure that the electrons have a negative charge and that the charges of the ions and the electrons are balanced. Depending on which exam board you do, ionic half equations may be referred to as just half equations. Let's have a look at how to write half equations for reduction reactions. Remember, reduction is the gain of electrons. Example 1 asks us to write an ionic half equation for the reduction of metal lead ions. The 2 in Roman numerals indicates that the lead ions have a 2+ charge. Each lead ion will therefore gain 2 electrons to form the element lead, the formula of which is simply its chemical symbol. This equation will score 1 mark. Example 2 asks for the ionic half equation for the reduction of sodium ions. Sodium is a metal in group 1 of the periodic table and forms ions with a 1+ charge. This ion will gain 1 electron to form sodium metal atoms, again the formula of which is simply its chemical symbol. The last example is slightly different, as this time you are writing the equation for the reduction of hydrogen ions, a non-metal ion. Hydrogen ions would be discharged at the cathode if the electrolysis involved an aqueous solution. Hydrogen atoms have 1 electron in their shell, so form ions with a single positive charge. We know that it will gain electrons, so we can write this in, because it's a reduction reaction, and the product form will be hydrogen gas, which has the formula H2. This equation will score you 1 mark because, as you can see, it is unbalanced. There are 2 hydrogen atoms on the right-hand side, but only 1 hydrogen ion on the left-hand side, so a 2 needs to be placed in front of this to make it balanced. If there are 2 hydrogen ions and each one has gained 1 electron, then that means 2 electrons have been gained in total, so again, this would need balancing in the equation. This half equation would now score 2 marks. In an exam, it's easy to remember how to write a half equation for a metal ion because the charge of the ion indicates the number of electrons gained. Let's have a look at how to write ionic half equations for oxidation reactions. Remember, oxidation involves the loss of electrons. In these half equations, the electrons being lost are shown on the right-hand side of the arrow. So let's have a look at the first example, which says write an ionic half equation for the oxidation of bromide ions. The element bromine is in group 7, so it will form ions with a 1 minus charge. Begin by writing this down and then draw your arrow and the electrons being lost on the right-hand side. Bromine, remember, is a diatomic molecule, so has the formula Br2. This equation would score 1 mark because, similar to the example we looked at for hydrogen, the atoms and ions for bromine are unbalanced. There are 2 bromine atoms on the right-hand side, but only 1 bromide ion on the left-hand side, so this is balanced by placing a 2 in front of the Br-. Each bromide ion will lose 1 electron, so if there are 2 bromide ions, each losing 1 electron, then 2 electrons are going to be lost in total, and again, this is balanced by placing a 2 in front of the E-. This equation will now score you 2 marks. Repeat this process for question 2, which asks you to write an ionic half equation for the oxidation of oxide ions. Oxygen is in group 6 of the periodic table, so forms ions with a 2- charge. The oxygen gas formed is diatomic and has the formula O2, and again, the electrons being lost are shown on the right-hand side of the equation. Similar to previous examples, this equation will score 1 mark. Again, we can see that on the right-hand side of the equation, there are 2 oxygen atoms, whereas on the left-hand side, there is only 1 iron. So this is balanced by placing a 2 in front of the O2 minus. A common mistake students make is by thinking that 2 electrons are lost in total. You've got 2 oxide ions, each losing 2 electrons. So actually, 4 electrons are lost in total. And it is a 4 that you need in front of your E minus to score the second mark. It's really important that you make sure the charges are balanced on each side of the equation. To summarise, ionic half equations show the oxidation reaction taking place at the anode and the reduction reaction taking place at the cathode. Oxidation is the loss of electrons and reduction is the gain of electrons, which can be memorised using the mnemonic oil rig. When writing an ionic half equation, make sure that the number of atoms and ions for each element is balanced, as well as the charges of the ions and the electrons. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.